A stroke occurs when a blood vessel that carries oxygen and nutrients to the brain is either blocked by a clot or bursts. When that happens, part of the brain cannot get the blood and oxygen it needs, so brain cells die. Did you know that there is a less common type of stroke that affects young people caused by trauma to the arteries of the neck? This is called cervical artery dissection, referring to the neck. Cervical artery dissection occurs when there's a tear in the carotid or vertebral artery of the neck. Here to talk with us about this unusual kind of stroke is Dr. Shadi Yagi, Associate Professor of Neurology and Vascular Neurology Division Chief at Alpert Medical School at Brown University. Dr. Yagi, welcome to House Calls.
Thanks for having me.
You are the lead author on a recently published paper that looks at a cause of stroke that accounts for a very small percentage of overall strokes, but a surprisingly high percentage of strokes among young people. Can you tell me more about this condition?
So this kind of stroke is called cervical artery dissection, or a tear in the artery of the neck that can sometimes lead to a stroke. It's not a common cause of stroke overall, 2% of strokes, but it accounts to about 25% of strokes in young people. And this is often caused by some sort of neck injury, and it generally happens in people who have certain predisposing factors, some genetic conditions that can predispose to tearing of the artery, or sometimes not a well-defined genetic disorder.
And how is this kind of stroke different from other kinds of stroke?
There are other causes of stroke, like hardening of the artery, like a condition called atrial fibrillation can cause a clot in the heart that can go to the brain and cause stroke. This is a different type of stroke, but the end result of all these causes of stroke is a stroke. So really important that if someone is having stroke symptoms, regardless of the cause, to seek medical attention, because there are treatments that could reverse the effects of the stroke.
I'm wondering if you can tell us more about the specific arteries involved with this kind of stroke. Why is it so important?
So this artery is in the neck. It's the carotid artery or the vertebral artery. It provides blood flow to the brain. When a tear happens, a clot can form at the site of the tear, and this clot can move up to the brain and cause a stroke, or this clot can potentially block the artery, impede blood flow to the brain, and lead to a stroke.
You mentioned that a neck injury can cause these kinds of strokes. What kind of neck injury are we talking about?
Certainly any trauma can cause it. It's more likely to happen in someone who's had a major car accident with fractures in the neck. Definitely they could have injury of their arteries in the neck. It could also be very minor or trivial trauma, like just turning the neck very fast, and that could potentially tear the artery, even coughing or sneezing hard. So it could be a minor trauma, and usually when it happens in the setting of minor trauma, this person has more of a predisposition to having it. Whereas, you know, with major trauma, there's usually no underlying predisposition.
That's good to know. And tell me a little bit more about who we're talking about. You said that cervical artery dissection accounts for about 25% of strokes in young people. Are we talking about people who are generally healthy?
Yeah, so generally, this is a healthy patient population. Again, they're young patients without much of risk factors. You know, these patients who have this don't have the traditional risk factors generally. They have a genetic predisposition and then some sort of environmental trigger. It could be an infection, it could be minor trauma to the neck, and that can lead to the tear in the artery. And really the most concerning thing about the tear in the artery when it happens is it could lead to a stroke that could potentially be devastating.
Let's talk about diagnosis. How can a doctor diagnose cervical artery dissection?
It is diagnosed by scans of the arteries, a CAT scan of the arteries, an MRI of the arteries, or going in with the catheter and injecting the eye and looking at the arteries with an angiogram. So these are tests that could diagnose it.
And once it's diagnosed, what treatment options are available?
The most important thing is to prevent stroke or lower the risk of stroke. And, you know, we use antithrombotic or anti-clotting medications to lower the risk of stroke. Generally, they're needed for about 3 to 6 months because this is the period where most of the strokes happen after this condition.
Let's recap some key takeaways. A cervical artery dissection is a tear in the artery of the neck that can sometimes lead to stroke. It accounts for only 2% of all strokes, but about 25% of strokes in young people. Cervical artery dissection can be caused by neck trauma, either major trauma like a neck fracture from a car accident, or sometimes minor trauma like sneezing hard. Sometimes this stroke presents without typical stroke symptoms, but instead with sudden neck pain or severe headache. If you experience new neck pain or a new headache that's not going away, you should talk to your doctor. If you have questions about health conditions, I'd love to hear from you. Comment below, hit subscribe, join me here next time for answers you can trust.